When Survival Is Not Enough on Smart Money next. Welcome to Smart Money. I'm Julia Anderson along with my co-host Pat Boyle. We have a return guest in Nick Poindexter with SINE, S-I-N-E, which stands for Survival Is Not Enough. And he's brought along Maddie Doe, who we're very happy to welcome to us on Smart Money. Maddie is an actual participant and member of the organization, and so we're happy to find out more about what it's all like. So we're going to start with Nick, and just remind us, what is SINE?
Absolutely. First of all, thank you for allowing us to be here again, and happy to have Maddie with us. Yeah. She's amazing, so I'm looking forward to her being able to share her experience. So SINE, as mentioned, is an acronym that stands for Survival Is Not Enough. Mm-hmm. It's an initiative of a nonprofit, The Contingent, and it launched in March 2021 to focus on supporting college graduates of color to really help to elevate them as they lean into, you know, creating a network to help them as they lean into their vocation and as they lean into their, as they build wealth and as they think about what does it look like to impact their respective
plan for retirement.
Exactly.
I'm trying to.
Exactly. And so really it's coming alongside them to support them with life after college and really walking with them in that journey. It's focused on four focus areas, leadership development, financial education, wealth building, and civic and community engagement. And we really want to make sure that we're elevating our leaders and walking with them and supporting them. And we hold ourselves accountable by actually creating a social mobility scorecard assessment. So what that looks like is really helping them to be able to us to be able to know how they're growing in those areas, to be able to then meet their needs in terms of what makes sense. So customizing what makes sense for intentional support.
So you're really tracking how it's going.
Exactly,
right.
Exactly.
What kind of things are you tracking?
Yeah, things like home buying, things like them progressing in their careers and getting promotions and raises, paying off student loan debt, 401k, like investing in 401ks, also thinking about what does it look like for them to give back and volunteer in the community, whether it be sitting on boards, et cetera.
So Maddie, when you look at financial literacy and personal wealth, what have you learned so far through this program?
My favorite things, my biggest memories of being a member is the transparency behind it and kind of taking away that assumption of everyone knows exactly what they're doing when it comes to financial literacy, because I think the truth is for most folks my age, no one knows what they're doing. We don't know where to begin, and so just being able to have that space and that intentional support that Nick was talking about and looking at our paychecks and knowing, why is this being deducted? Where does it go to? How much should we be putting away? Knowing that that 20% isn't feasible for everybody to put away into their paycheck towards retirement or towards college loans or towards their car payments, and kind of working with all of each other to see what works best for the financial plan for us. And so kind of taking away that assumption that we all should know exactly what we're supposed to be doing has been my favorite memory and
how long
thing
have
I've
been
learned the best.
In the program?
I was actually a member of the beta program, and so that was the summer of 2021 and engaged ever since then. But our group actually still talks frequently, and technically the program has been completed for our cohort, but it's still ongoing. So,
were there any surprises for you that were completely something new that you didn't even know about?
Yeah. I guess a financial fun fact that I learned during the program was, especially during the pandemic, I think a lot of us were just confused with student loan payments being put on pause, hearing a lot about interest rates, and just all of the uncertainty. And then my favorite financial fun fact that I learned was that when you're paying your credit card payment, you could do it in 2 or 3 increments and chip away at it, and it actually helps your credit score in the long run, because you're able to chip away at it.
No.
I didn't know that.
Okay, that's everyone's financial fun fact for the day.
No.
And it makes it a little bit more digestible for young folks who are trying to still figure out our way. So,
did the program help you set your financial goals, or let's say one of your goals was, I want to buy a car and have it paid for? Are you guided toward more grounded financial goals, or talk about that process.
Absolutely. For me, it was purchasing a car. During my time in Sign, I was actually purchased my, I don't like the word used, so I say pre-loved. I purchased a pre-loved car and walked through with my mentors who were actually able to help connect me to other financial experts about what made sense, like with interest rates, how much I should put down for a down payment, and what is feasible with my budget, and being able to talk through that process with experts. Yeah. So I'm chipping away at my car payment still, and without the support from the Sign community, and being able to feel like that was something that I was able to take on comfortably, and that big financial decision, it was really amazing. So,
great. What kind of time commitment is required of the member? And there's also a member's circle. I think you were kind of referring to that, to your cohort.
Yeah, absolutely. So for members, so the first step is once they apply, they would, if they're accepted, they would move forward with an orientation. And so that orientation really helps prepare them for the mentoring experience, but also to join Sign. What is Sign all about? What to expect? And really prepares them as they launch into that. And from there, it's there also is an optional but strongly encouraged financial fundamentals course where they'll learn about debt, paying off debt and managing credit and all of those things to really help them to think about even their relationship to money. What does that look like? Because each person, their experience with money looks different. And so beyond that, then they dive into a mentoring circle. So the mentoring circle, 3 mentors, 5 to 9 members. Really that group mentoring experience so they can work with each other, because all of them are coming in with different strengths and different experiences. And so the great thing is they're able to support each other. And somebody might be have a lot of knowledge about this, or maybe in terms of 401k, maybe they've learned about all that already, or somebody's coming with learning about paying off credit. But the nice thing is they're able to come together and share in their experiences. And so that's meeting once a month for 1 to 2 hours during their first year of Sign. And that's really committed to those 4 focus areas I mentioned, but also discussions and guest speakers and different activities to really help them to continue to grow and excel to, and also build rapport with one another. And so that's really what we want, to build community, but also help them to know to walk along that journey in their first year. And then beyond that, we really want to continue to keep them connected through different opportunities and experiences as well.
So how many hours a week would you say that was?
Yeah, I mean, it's 1 to 2 hours a month, and in some instances, there might be circles that where the mentor is meeting with, members one-on-one. Mm-hmm. It really depends. We actually have a guidebook that we provide for mentors, and it's really not we have the basics of at least 1 to 2 hours a month meeting in a circle, but beyond that, it's really what makes sense for the respective circles, because we know it's not a one-size-fits-all approach, right. And we want to make sure that they're able to lean in. We provide support and resources, but we want them to lean in terms of what makes sense for each circle, because all the members are different and all the mentors are different.
Maybe you can both address this, and another aspect of your support is helping people with leadership skills. So what are you getting out of that part of it?
It was, for me, I think my cohort, we were all pretty comfortable in, at least in our college experiences, with leadership and taking on those roles. And I, at least for me, coming into Portland, coming back home into the city again, was feeling that imposter syndrome of being a young person, but having those skills and not knowing exactly where to go with it. And so being able to chat with our fellow cohort mates about other board opportunities, volunteer opportunities, but then also the resources with Sign, but our mentors as well.
I've got to interrupt you. What's the imposter syndrome? Did you just say
imposter syndrome?
Did you say that?
Yes.
What is that?
You might be able to speak to it better, but at least in my experience in it is when you're in spaces where you feel like you don't deserve to be there. You feel like you might not have, even though you have worked for that position or you've worked for that responsibility, kind of just your experiences make you feel like you don't belong. And it's particularly prevalent in young people, people of color, and women.
And women.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, she hit on the imposter syndrome, really feeling like you don't belong when you really do.
Right. That's what really, you're there, you got the degree.
Yeah. And that's what we want to do, is reinforce folks like Maddie who are already amazing, saying you have what it takes, you're exceptional, continue to elevate them to remind them of they're already amazing, and continue to help them to support them along the way.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's the worst boogeyman.
How has your network of people grown since you've joined the program?
Immensely, both in quality and quantity. And I think that just with peer-to-peer, but then also into that leadership network within Portland itself. And so one of the things that I've really appreciated is because members like myself, you have to apply to be in the program, but then mentors, also apply to be a mentor. And everyone's selected and interviewed, and so there's a strong desire to be there intentionally. Nobody has to be there. And so the quality of folks who come together, it's all with a shared goal of working to help with the recognition that survival is not enough. And so trying to help us all find our way in the world.
So Nick, we had you on last year and we got the basics of SIGN, and you had a membership then of, I was surprised, it was quite a few people involved, like Maddie is. So where are you now?
Absolutely. So we reached over 120 SIGN members.
That's great.
Had our third cohort and largest cohort just start in the fall, so it was over 60 members. And we'll start up again, we'll be recruiting in the coming months for a start for our fourth cohort in the fall. And so each sort of cohort's getting a little bit bigger, and yeah, we're excited to have over 120 SIGN members.
Great, yeah. That's great.
How does it work? Because I understand you cover all of Oregon and Southwest Washington, urban and rural. If you have a rural candidate, how hard is it to connect that person to everybody else? I mean, Zoom is your friend, or how does that work?
So, so SIGN was established in March 2021, which is right in the midst of the pandemic, and so a lot of the circles are actually virtual. So the nice thing is you can be anywhere, and we've actually had some, the hope is that folks will, it's sort of serving, Oregon, Southwest Washington, but we have had some folks that maybe have moved for an opportunity where some have been in Washington, D.C. or in the Midwest, and they're still getting, still staying connected with their circles. And so it's virtual, and then in terms of meeting in person is what makes sense for that group. For instance, one example is we have a circle that'll be meeting later in August, and they are already planning for it, and they have somebody that's in the Dalles that is going to be driving in, and they have other folks that will be like coming together, and so they really want to meet intentionally in person. So it's really about we recruit Oregon, Southwest Washington, and really wanting to make sure that folks are served and being intentional about that. And that's why we did create the virtual sort of curriculum to be able to meet folks where they are.
So not only are you recruiting young people, recent graduates of college, there are people of color, you're also recruiting mentors. And so throughout your experience with SIGN, who were some of your favorite mentors and why did you like them?
Well, my two mentors are both my favorites. And shout out to Doug and Joe. but they really took the time, and I think it was unique because it was the first group to go. So we all kind of walked in and said, I don't know exactly how it's gonna go, but we'll figure it out together. And it's that kind of that intention of the desire to want to help uplift the next generation was apparent from them from the first time we all met. And so I've bothered them with many questions about SIGN related things, but work and life, and it's become a true friendship and also a mentorship. And I think that's been a strong theme throughout all of our cohorts, at least. We all feel like they're accessible and they're not far away, and we can't not bother them. And
so you can call them up pretty much any time.
We send memes, we're Instagram friends. and I think that space to feel safe and ask those questions has really made that relationship go where it is. And so they're like the cool aunt and uncle you want to bother and
there
ask
you go.
All the questions too.
That's nice to have.
I like that.
Yes.
Now, is SIGN unique to Oregon, or is it a part of a national organization?
Yes, SIGN is unique to Oregon, and focus on, as mentioned, the Oregon and Southwest Washington region. Mm-hmm. We are looking at what does it look like to expand to other areas. A lot of the presence is primarily, a significant key presence is in Portland Metro. We do have, as I mentioned, folks that are part of other communities in Oregon and Southwest Washington, but our hope is to continue to expand through Oregon and potentially nationally, and really in an intentional and thoughtful way that meets the needs of the communities and based off what that looks like. So right now we're in the process of just evaluating what does it look like to expand and scale beyond our region.
Cool.
Yeah.
Great. So if you wanted to find out more about SIGN, how do you do that?
Absolutely. So one way is through our website, so that's signup.org, so that's SINEUP.org, and that'll give information for folks that maybe want to support as backers, which are basically businesses or other entities that want to provide financial support or relational support. We also folks can sign up to be members and mentors. Right now, they would just fill out an interest form, and then we will open up recruitment. They'd be able to apply and sort of start that process. And they can learn more through our website and connecting with us through our social media accounts, et cetera. And so those are a couple of the main ways to get connected.
So Maddie, we didn't find out actually, you graduated from where and what's your first job? What are you doing?
I'm a graduate, a first generation college graduate from the University of Oregon. I graduated in 2019, thank you. And my summer after graduation, I actually did the Emerging Leaders Program, which is a sister program of SIGN, and then went straight into my first job. I worked down in Salem in government relations.
For a private company?
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
What's it like to get that paycheck?
It's nice, and it's really nice being a part of a group that helps me digest it and be smart with my finances and know that I'm on the right track to do something besides just having it sit in a checking account.
There you go.
And paying all the things I need to pay.
Yeah, and the quicker you pay all that off, the better, and then start that retirement program right now.
Absolutely.
All that.
She can tell you lots more.
We should talk. You should be a mentor.
Well, I told Nick that, but I've got to go to your website and sign up.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. I actually created my high yield savings account when I was with SIGN.
So bravo. Yeah,
so got a logo in that way too.
We've been talking with Nick Poindexter and Maddie Doe with SIGN. Survival is not enough. It's a great program, it sounds like to us.
Really,
we were glad to have you back. And if you want to find out more about SIGN, it should be signup.org. Is that right?
Yes, SINEUP.org.
Very good. Thanks for being on Smart Money.
Head to youtube.com/MACTVCTV for more Smart Money episodes. Please send Smart Money comments and tips to smartmoney@gmail.com.
Follow me, Julia Anderson, at 60andsingle.com.
Smart Money is available for informational purposes only and is not liable for errors or omissions or any damages arising from its content.